Hello everybody and welcome back to American Truck Simulator. We're here on our fresh start profile here, and you'll never guess what I did. We got it. This is the Pinga 379. I'll fix it up a little bit. We still got a little bit of money left over. I found it in a used truck dealership. I'm working on putting a skin on there for it. Not having very good luck at that so far. Yeah, we got the N14 and a 13 speed. Alright, let's hook up to our trailer and right here. Oh yeah, the new Gamer Donnie logo. Still a work in progress. You can't see all around the mirror or the stacks. This is that truck. Can't open the door, stick your head out either. Hit us a load. Well, it was red and black for this game, kind of here. I thought it looked pretty good. It's either that or blue, but I think the red looks good. Alright, cargo market. Where the fuck are we at? Oh, Montrose. Oh, there we are. We got Thunderbirds. Yeah, the weights. I think I put a number in the wrong spot when I was editing the line. So the weights are just fucking stupid ridiculous. So, yeah, that's, I'll have to fix that. Let's go pick up these 73,000 pound motorcycles. Did I not click it? Or is it here? N14 engine, so. N14 Pittsburgh. Not being able to look out the window is going to make it backing up a little challenging in some spots. What the fuck did I hit? That's telling me it's somewhere else. I thought it was here. I'm gonna back up and hit the icon. Fucking GPS. I wanna see what the hell I hit. Oh, I hit the fence, okay. Thank you.
turn right.
Jake brakes sound a little bit better, but it's all right.
Keep right, and then turn right.
Safe and sound. Got the big old gear shifter sticking up there. How about you? £71,000 of motorcycle. That's a lot of fucking motorcycles. Skip the back end. We got a big hill to climb too. Going down the $1 million highway. Clean green. Work with me here. What time is it? It is noon 20. So we'll be there by 3. Might take a little bit longer than that. Gonna be a slow climb up that hill. Episode for the fresh start. We've completed our goal. No, I'm still gonna be doing it. I'm seriously thinking about maybe another fresh start, but this one. She's eating always and had wiped off. That's my doing. I accidentally did it and started it on her.
Keep right and then continue straight on. Go straight on. Keep right and then continue straight on.
Oh, fuck you, tractor. Shit.
Go straight on.
Oh, well, it's gonna be a slime clow. Slow climb, anyway. Yeah, you turn your bitch ass off.
Right.
There you go.
And then continue straight on.
Glad they got rid of the damn hot combine harvesters, but they bring back the damn tractor. I used to hate those damn combines. Seen those notifications? I haven't been paying attention. I've got like 19 of them popped up. I don't think it records it. So loud in my headset's, what's that equalizer thing, the volume equalizer. cutting, making it quieter. Need to push? Please put some lights around the bottom of the cab of the truck and on the grill. Put a little Christmas tree on the dash and bounce back and forth and songs. Come hauling ass down through there. the fuck? I did that to me earlier too. That actually, the odometer actually worked too. It says 106 on it. Yeah, it is. That's pretty cool. Cars, people driving down the interstate reading a fucking book, taking a nap, cars running like 60-80. I wouldn't be able to do it. Not for me. I don't have that much faith in technology. I can barely program the remote for TV. Scar on my, what's that thing called in your eye there? The cornea. It makes everything look all blurry. So it looks like you're looking through a scratched piece of glass. And the other, I'm colorblind in, so I'm just double fucked. see smoke rolling. I think I'm not a bus driver. Nobody would ride with me. Nobody would want to ride. I'd get you there. Get you there fast. Everybody lean to the right. Go around the curve. Fuck me, come on. 20 minutes left. 5 miles. 5 minutes left on the clock. Ooh, what I got here? Want you a real man? You gonna say something else, but I think you should keep your mouth shut about it. Every damn red light we're gonna hit. If I'm a good loping engine. Besides that M11. Fuck, 16 minutes. And the race is on, you come right in the back stretch. There's a little playground over there. That's pretty cool. I like it when they add little shit like that into the game. I'm all about the little details. Ooh, we just blew the truck up. So what you did, GPS talking to me, got me all confused. We almost blew the bottom out of the engine.
Finally, we are here.
Oh, what's the sound so confused? Pretty good from the outside. I'm not a real big fan of low profile tires, but I think it looks alright. Miles, 619 minutes, 45.4 gallons of fuel, $32,665 earned. Okay, let's see if we get another load here. How long is it? Alright, we got enough. Let's say we go to Santa Fe. Haven't been there in a while. Oh shit, it's nighttime too. Wait, why is one purple and the other one's red? Looks alright. I got those skulls on the bumper. It's supposed to be like vampire teeth or some shit running down. I don't know. Smoking crack when I made it.
Drive safe.
I think it's one of those buildings we can just go circle all the way around and come back up through the parking lot. Nope. Got this thing stretched out a little bit. Come on, camera, work on me here. I'll back it into the little spot we just pulled out of. Then I'll turn to the right.
Let's find a new route.
Shut up, or you can back this damn thing up yourself. Keep it on the fence over there. Wait a minute. We can't go out that way. Motherfucker. I thought this was one of those ones where it's blocked off.
Go straight on.
What a dumbass. Should've looked. Shitty quality anyway, it's like 10-20 or something. But a Chuck was climbing a Peterbilt 379, was climbing a big steep hill, and he's had a big industrial something on it, I don't know what it's called. And he had one of those oversized trailers, kind of like those low boys that are in Reconstruction Blader. He had a set of them. He was about halfway up the hill, and then when the load starts pulling, twists the drive line. He's in there hitting the brakes, trying to keep it from rolling backward. Retard's trying to throw a piece of wood underneath the tire like that's going to do anything.
Straight on.
Son of a like I said, one of our goals, our next goal is to fill out the garage and terminal in Dallas. There's 5 trucks, 5 drivers. Should be rolling in some cash. best is would easily be freedom. You know, you don't have somebody watching over your shoulder 24/7, micromanaging. And you're alone. Some people don't like that. I like my alone time, my peace and quiet. Taking risks that you normally wouldn't take. It's not that bad of a company, they're just big. Got a lot of new drivers, like I said, high turnover rates.
Turn left.
I think the best company I worked for was Snyder. They treat you like, you know, family, like you're part of the family. They give you a lot more freedom too. Like, you don't have to go certain routes. If a different route is faster or you want to go down, that's fine as long as the mileage isn't, you know, higher. They basically tell you, pick up this load here, drop that load off there at this time. However you get there, that's you. Then if you keep average speed of 55, you get like a, what was it, $250 bonus every month? Plus another bonus for safety, if you don't have no accidents. I remember the first truck they gave me, it was a Freightliner Century. They had over a million miles on the thing. Air leaks left and right. I mean, there wasn't bad enough that DOT would shut you down or anything, but when you would start the truck back up, you'd have to build air pressure.
Keep right and then turn right.
It was a piece.
Turn right.
Well, I guess the truck that I blew the turbo out of going through Kentucky. Up in the mountains. Turbo blew and shit started smoking. I said I had enough. But I got a better truck out of the deal, so no biggie. Definitely one hell of an adventure. I loved every minute of it. Still do.
Turn right.
Next day always brings something new. Go to bed, it's 70 degrees outside, you wake up and there's fucking a foot of snow on the ground. I never mind driving in the snow, really. I kind of liked it, it's a good challenge. Had to throw chains on it three or four times, I think. Going up over Donner Pass a couple times and
this is where it ends.
Running down the East Coast. It's not as bad as everybody makes it out to be. I set up on Donner Pass for 6-7 hours before the cop came through and told everybody to turn around and go back. So what the hell am I been sitting here all this time for? So I got went back there and made me a sandwich and chips and got something to eat. It's pretty bad. 187 miles, 5 hours, 16 minutes, 44 gallons of fuel. That's $28,316 in my pocket. Almost level 22. Wonder what that's going to be, professional. So, I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to,
don't forget to like.
Yeah.
Subscribe. Share. And leave a comment down below. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.
Yeah, I need to fix that. See you in the next video. It should be see you on the next video. Or something like that. Next video. There you go.